A stupid computer mouse can cost you your job? What the hell? Watch this. Hello friends, welcome back to GK Code Labs. Sorry for such a long delay in my next upload. Actually, I was stuck in some other serious work, so I could not upload new content for you guys on my channel. Anyways, to cover that up, for a start, I would like to discuss one very interesting as well as very serious problem here. And as you guys love a practical scenario on my channel, if you are working on a Linux environment, I will bring something related to you. 75% of big data community uses Linux as a day-to-day environment. It is sort of interesting to enjoy, you know, if someone else faces it, but equally serious and can make you even cry if you do it yourself by mistake. A really stupid mistake that can cost you your job. I'm not kidding. Yes, it is related to rm command in Linux. Most of you have been told, use that carefully. And come on, obviously we, the GK Code Labs community, have that common sense, right? That we need to use rm command carefully because it removes the files. So you are confident that you intentionally won't type the command rm before confirming twice. Fair enough. What if I tell you, you can lose your job even if you take care of all this stuff, but only if your small hardware like a mere mouse or keyboard is defective. If you are starting to use Linux, either for big data or other applications, please watch this video to avoid any such mistake which you can make unknowingly. Let's suppose I have a virtual machine that is Ubuntu. I log into it. For just a simple explanation, suppose if you have a folder in some directory, let's say system. This is some of your system directory, which has three folders, bin, com, and conf, which has different respective files. Inside bin directory, you have four another folders, 1, 2, 3, 4, and some files, a, b, c. .txt. This is a usual scenario. This is a virtual VM that you can face, you might face in some of your production environments, that you have a virtual machine where you have to connect this machine from your Windows environment. This is a Linux environment, and to this Linux environment, you might have a requirement to connect it through a Windows environment. Let's say from Windows environment, I want to connect to this machine through PuTTY. And the requirement is that inside this desktop system bin directory, I want to just remove this directory number 2, or you can say desktop slash system slash bin slash 2. Fair enough, right? Let's go to my Windows environment and try to connect to this machine. Before we try to connect to this machine, we want to know the IP address of this machine. To know that, let me check the IP of this machine. For doing that, let's go to the terminal and do ip addr show. If you are thinking why I am not using ifconfig or ifconfig, that is a utility that has to be installed externally. So ip addr show will work out of the box for most of the Linux environments. Let's see what this gives us. So if you can see here, on my local connection, it is giving me the IP of 192.168.0.1.0.3. Fine. I'll copy this, go to my local Windows environment. I'll open the PuTTY, paste this and open. I'll give my credentials. Fair enough. I logged into my Linux environment. That is the same which I have logged into through my VirtualBox. I'll close this. I'll go to my home. Now, what do I want to do? I want to go inside system, bin, and I want to remove just this directory. Make sure inside system directory, I might have many other files, many other application production files. I'm not sure what all I have. I just am asked to remove directory number 2. Now what am I going to do? I'll cd to home. I know the system directory is on my desktop. I'll go to my desktop. Then I know the directory name is system. Fine. Inside the desktop, I have a system directory. Inside system, I have to remove a directory named 2, correct? So I'll move into this directory, and very beautifully Linux provides us a solution that if you want to run multiple commands in one shot, you can separate it by a semicolon, like change directory to this and remove a directory name 2. So let's see what we are going to run. Cd to this path, then colon. Now we have to remove the directory 2, and for removing a directory we have to use rf, that is 2, correct? So we are changing the directory to system bin and removing rm-rf 2. Everything goes fine till here, right? Till system bin, and we have to remove this directory. Now suddenly what happens? The main concept of this video. Sometimes you might be aware of, like, the right click of your mouse might misbehave, or if you are using your keyboard and that is defective, the insert key that you use, that might be defective. It is a rare scenario, but I can tell you many people have faced this. Even I myself have faced this around 4 years back, and somehow I managed to recover everything back. But seriously, it was a nightmare. So what I'm talking about is, you copied one command to cd to change the directory, and you pasted this command, and after that you knew how to rm-rf2, that is the directory you wanted to remove, but your right click of your mouse misbehaved. I'll show you right now how this can happen. Let me copy this. Suppose you have copied this, and close this. No, I don't want to save it. Let's change this. So you have copied this already, right? I'll paste it. Then I want to remove the directory 2, and now accidentally you press the right click or any key on the keyboard, and the same command gets entered again, and you are so quick to enter the command that you are so pro in Linux that you enter it so quickly without noticing what got entered, correct? We'll go through this command later. Let's see what happened here. What happened here exactly? Let us see. System, where is the bin directory? It's gone, right? Entire bin directory is gone. What if some application or some of your code, or we can say any of your production environment was there in that directory? Everything is gone just with a missed right click. Let's see what went wrong. Here you just copied cd to this directory. You got cd into this directory, and very smartly you put a semicolon and did rm-rf to remove the directory number 2. But accidentally the same command got pasted again. So the cd command says you have to change directory till this path, because now there is next semicolon and the command is terminated. And the rm-rf command says you have to remove, be it a file or a directory, named 2cd. There is no file or directory named 2cd, correct? Or the second argument for this rm-rf is this entire directory. So it happens to remove the second argument directory, that is bin. And as you can see, the bin directory is totally gone. So this was a very weird example, but a very important one, so as to make you realize the importance of rm command. See guys, if you are using Linux, you are handling a very powerful tool. Whether you realize it or not, you use it on your local or your cloud or your production environment, it's all up to you, but you have to be careful. More big data videos are yet to come up, and all of my subscribers, thank for you to comment on my videos. I'll be surely answering all of your questions, probably in form of a video, and will try to make you a master of big data in coming few months. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done. Thank you for being with us. Have a nice day.